Snowpack is declining around the world. So here in Utah, looking back to the 1950s, we're seeing declines of 40 to 50% of total snowpack in just 60 or 70 years. And so anything that changes how snowpack melts or accumulates or persists is an important thing that we need to understand, not only for the basic science of it, but also for Utah's water, farming, and other challenges that are coming. A lot of factors dictate how snowpack melts. So a major one is how much sun hits it. And then the other side of that is how much sun is reflected back. So snow is the most reflective natural surface on Earth, but any change to that surface affects how much solar radiation it accumulates and how much it will then melt. And so that can be anything from the snow itself melting, but that can also be stuff like dust.
So I'm just looking at the top layer of the snow for any impurities, any dust that might have fallen. I'm just trying to get a sense of the snow crystal structure. So this is really freshly fallen, dry, fresh snow. So this is really reflective.
But it's not just dust. Other biological agents can also affect how snow melts. And so there's this really interesting organism, it's an algae called snow algae, that actually grows on mountain snowfields around the world. And so it starts and is precipitated by when there is enough meltwater in the snowpack, often in late spring and early summer. And these blooms will develop on the surface of a snowfield. They're dark red, and that dark pigment that's in the algae causes it to absorb heat, which causes snow to melt. And so what we're working to understand in collaboration with folks at the University of Montana and University of Minnesota is what precipitates snow algal blooms? Why do they exist? What controls their size and their scale and their magnitude? How much do they actually affect snowpack melt in Utah and Washington and Montana and other places in the West? And how's that going to change? Snow algae right now isn't necessarily a problem for Utah's snowpack. But if these snow algal blooms are gonna become larger and more frequent in the years and decades to come, that could mean our snowpack's gonna melt more quickly, thereby influencing downstream water resources.